it is a lot of work, and it's quite a commitment because this is a big system, and it's a big responsibility to be on the board. You know, you kind of get into it, you get out of it, I guess, what you put into it.
That's Larry Schmidt, a Towson attorney who was appointed and served on the Baltimore County School Board from 2009 to 2015. The county is moving from an all-appointed school board to a hybrid board. 7 members will be elected this year, and 5 members will be appointed. Like many others, Schmidt believes there are pros and cons to having elected members, like accountability.
Smith, Gilday, and Schmidt, this is Alyssa. Can I help you?
I can tell you, as a member of the board during that time, we heard those criticisms. We tried to be responsive to the public. We felt like we were in many cases and felt like sometimes our message maybe didn't get out. But with that being said, we didn't run for election, so obviously that's the ultimate accountability.
Baltimore County is not alone in changing up its school board. Here in Anne Arundel County, they're moving to an all-elected school board with some seats up this election year and others in 2 years.
There's something for consistency. That's a nice thing when you've got a board that is with you and gets and knows and understands that school system, because every school system, every community is different, the needs and aspirations and those kinds of things. So, but at the same time, when you get new people on board, they do. They look at things differently. They've got a different lens. They've got a different perspective, and I think that's healthy.
That's Anne Arundel County Superintendent George Arlotto. He's hoping his relationship with board members doesn't change dramatically as the county makes the switch.
I'm going to continue to operate the same way. It doesn't really matter to me whether, however the board members are 9 and soon to be 8 board members get to us in Anne Arundel County, it has no impact on me in terms of how I'm going to operate on a day-to-day basis. I try and build relationships, and I think all superintendents try and do that.
Superintendent Arlotto says he has one-on-one monthly meetings with board members. The 30-year-plus education veteran believes that teamwork with the board helps to keep things on track and get goals accomplished. I asked him if he believes the average person really understands how much goes into being on a school board.
It's interesting, over the years I've watched board members become very wide-eyed as they see how much it takes to run basically a billion-dollar business, where you've got the lives in Anne Arundel County of 83,000 students and 12,000 employees each and every day that you're responsible for.
I'm Abby Baton. I'm the president of the Teachers Association of Baltimore County, better known as TABCO. Having a hybrid in many ways hopefully will help to make sure that our board is diverse, not only ethnically, but the types of people who are on there.
Voters in Baltimore County will select 7 members with 5 appointed as part of the new makeup of the school board. The head of the teachers union is hopeful for more educators on that board, but knows it's important to have a mix of professions.
But there are also people that understand budgets. We want to make sure that they are on there. A lawyer on there isn't a bad thing either. It's just that it shouldn't be all lawyers. It shouldn't be all business people. It needs to be a fair number of educators who understand public education.
The best part was, to me, was obvious, and that was the interaction with the kids and just feeling that maybe in some small way you were doing something that was going to positively impact one of our students.
Back in Towson with former school board member Larry Schmidt, who says being on the school board had its challenges.
The system is so big and it's so diverse. What may work at Towson High School may not work at Woodlawn High School, may not work at Chesapeake High School, may not work at Lansdowne High School. And I think spending at least the beginning months or period of time trying to educate yourself to the way the system is run and the way the system works and the challenges of the system is the best advice I can give.